We are going to construct a right angle triangle with hypotenuse C such that the median drawn to the hypotenuse is the geometric mean of the two legs of the triangle. This geometry problem comes from the first International Mathematical Olympiad held in the year 1959. In order to construct this right angle triangle, we will first figure out the properties of the right angle triangle that we want to construct. And the rule of construction is that you can only draw angles, lines, or shapes using a compass and a straight edge, without a scale or measurement. And this is what we meant by geometric construction in Euclidean geometry. So let's actually consider the desired right angle triangle ABC with hypotenuse C and the other two lengths A and B, with the median as square root of A times B. The first thing that we know is that C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared by the Pythagoras theorem. And what we also know is that the median actually meets the circumcenter of the right angle triangle ABC, which we denote as the point O, which is also the midpoint of the side AC, due to the fact that AC is the diameter of the circumcircle. So, this means that half of the length C is actually the same as the length of the median, which is square root of AB, because the lengths OA, OC, and OB are all equal to the circumradius. Now, what we have are two pieces of information about the triangle ABC, and we are now going to piece them together into a property that will help us to construct the triangle. Okay, so let's square both sides of the second equation and multiply both sides by 2. Then add it to the first equation and we will end up with an equivalent condition that 3 over 2 c squared is equal to a squared plus b squared plus 2ab, which is the square of a plus b. Taking the square root both sides, we have the square root of 3 over 2 times c is equal to a plus b. So if we were to construct the triangle ABC, it needs to fulfill this condition. And seeing the quantity a plus b, we can come up with this length if we let d be the point on the extension of the line AC, such that the lengths BC and CD are the same, which we see that the length AD is just a plus b, which is square root of 3 over 2 times c. And most importantly, we know that the angle ADB is 45 degrees, since the triangle CDB is an isosceles right angle triangle. And with the two information that the sum of the lengths A and B is square root of 3 over 2 times C, and the angle ADB is 45 degrees, we are actually ready to construct the triangle ABC. From the given hypotenuse C, we can construct a length square root of 3 over 2 C as follows. We first draw a segment XY with length C, and two circles with radius xy centered at x and y respectively. If we label one of the intersections of the two circles as z, we see that the triangle xyz is an equilateral triangle with side length c. Now, if we construct a perpendicular from the point z to segment xy, we have the length zm is equal to square root of 3 over 2 times c. Now, take the length zm. We can draw a circle with radius zm centered at the point M and let z prime be the antipodal line of z. We can then construct the perpendicular bisector of the segment zz prime and denote S as the intersection point of the perpendicular bisector and the circle. Then the triangle zms is an isosceles right angle triangle with the length ZS equals to square root of 3 over 2 times C. And this is the length that we want to construct. Now, we proceed with the construction of the triangle ABC by first drawing the length square root of 3 over 2 C from A to D. We then construct a ray emanating from D and a circle with radius C centered at A such that they both intersect at a point B. Lastly, the point C can be constructed by dropping a perpendicular from B to line AD. So, this completes the construction of the triangle ABC. And the last thing to do is to verify that this is indeed the desired triangle ABC. This is essentially the reverse direction of what we have done at the start. That is by our construction. A plus B is equal to square root of 3 over 2 times C, and squaring both sides of the equation, we get that A squared plus B squared plus 2AB is equal to 3 over 2 C squared. And because the triangle ABC we have constructed is a right angle triangle, A squared plus B squared is equal to C squared. And so you will get that AB is equal to C squared over 4, or square root of AB is equal to C over 2, which is the condition given in the problem. Hence, this completes the proof. If you enjoy watching this video, please give it a like and make sure to check out this geometry problem from the 2010 IMO shortlist. I will see you in that video.